Before I introduce Travis, let me play you a clip of his number one song, After a Few. But after a few drinks, it's always the same. That song, massive song, heard on the radio all the time, but took forever to get to number one.
Like 1.2 years, I think, is what you said.
Literally.
Yeah.
Which may be the longest in history.
It is the longest run to number one and the longest on the country chart.
Did you make even more money because it took longer?
Yeah, a little bit more. The money hasn't all come in yet. Yeah. Like, it's usually like 9 months behind. But no, it's all been really good. I've been pretty happy with it.
He's gonna play his new song coming up in a second. I'd be pretty happy with it too.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it's been great, to be honest with you. But hey, I mean, the slow climb's good for songwriting.
Travis is in studio again. He's in a few weeks ago. But he came in, I just called him, said, come play your banjo up here. And so I said, in exchange, come in and promote your new song whenever you're ready. And you're going to do a song called Abby in a minute, which is not about a girl named Abby.
No, it's about anybody but you.
Get it?
Yeah.
It's an anagram or an enagram, acronym.
Acronym.
Yeah. One of those.
So what does your current girlfriend think about you writing a song about another girl that's not her?
Well, I got lucky right off the bat that I actually did not write this song. This is the only song I've cut that I didn't write, so that's good. But no, she, you know, she gets it. She's the Abby. She's the anybody but you.
Mm.
But yeah, it's a little weird. It was at first.
I saw you post on Instagram a really sweet message to her for her birthday. You guys have been together 2 years.
Yeah,
right?
2 years.
And you were like, oh, maybe it wasn't her birthday. Maybe it was just celebrating the anniversary.
Yeah, we've been dating for like 2 years.
And how has that been?
It's been wonderful. Honestly, great. And even during the pandemic, I feel like we've just gotten closer and, I mean, have had a great time. I feel like we haven't really butt heads that hard. So I guess that's been like the ultimate test of like, you know, when we first started dating, I was on the road all the time. And then now I'm not on the road at all, but we still get along pretty well.
And so she is, and we've mentioned this on the show before, she's the daughter of John Michael Montgomery, country music legend. Does he ever give you advice or tell you, hey, dummy, don't do this or don't do that from what he learned?
Oh, absolutely. We've talked a lot about music, and it's so interesting, like, going through things right now, and I bring it up to him, and he just laughs because he's like, yeah, I mean, I went through the same thing. You know, he called me when I got the ACM nomination and just him talking about when he was nominated for things and what it takes to get there, and it's really cool. Every conversation ultimately turns into like a fishing conversation, though. He's like, hey, that's congrats. So did you get that new transducer on the front of your boat? I'm like, oh, yeah, I did. You know, and then we just talk about that.
What's the best and worst thing about having him as a father-in-law? A future father-in-law. We'll
dang.
Say that.
Yeah,
my bad, my bad, my bad. My bad, my bad.
You too, huh? Getting on me there. Best thing, I think actually probably the best thing is that Madison totally gets what I do and gets that I have to be gone sometimes, be on the road because she grew up with it and understands it. Worst thing, I don't know. I mean, honestly, I've had a blast getting to know both of her parents.
You got to give us a worst, Travis.
A worst. God, let me think. Man, I don't know. You know, sometimes
yeah.
He just kind of, you like, you're talking to him.
Yeah.
And I just don't know if he hears you.
Okay, I hear that. Hey, come on in. Hey, Scuba Steve. We're gonna put some headphones on you. We didn't realize you couldn't hear us talking here. All right.
My clip up. Yeah.
Can you hear me in your ears?
Oh yeah, I got you.
On the phone right now is John Michael Montgomery.
Hey.
Oh man. Hey John.
Who the heck are you and what have you done with my daughter?
Oh man. Hey, I forgot to send you a picture, but I caught some fish on that active target the other day.
Oh yeah. Hey, man. I'm excited about we got to do some fishing trips together, obviously. But congratulations on your success and everything. It's fun to watch you and my son Walker. You know, being the young guys y'all are, doing everything you're doing, like I, you know, back in my days. But more than anything, I'm impressed with. I have to admit that right now you are. You know, people don't know Travis is a tremendous athlete. He is the Montgomery household undefeated ping pong champion.
That is true. The only person who's ever actually beat me a few times is John, because John, you got that kind of like hustle thing where you're like, oh, I'm not that good anymore, but you got that hardcore over the top spin that you throw on it.
Well, you know, I'll try to throw some old school shots on you, you know, because back in my day, you know, that was unbeatable. But, you know, I was like, once I thought I'd kind of start getting my old young ways back, but, you know, you still got me. But I'm going to get you before it's over with.
Oh,
but,
it's happening. It's happening.
So let me ask you a couple questions. John Michael Montgomery is on with us. When your daughter first goes, hey, I'm dating this guy, Travis, the first time you met Travis, how did you feel about him?
Oh, you know, I thought he was a really nice young man, you know, a very raised very well. And I just got to meet his parents the other day, and it confirmed what I thought. You know, I mean, he comes from a very good family. And you know, when your daughter's dating someone, I mean, you just you know, I mean, when you got a daughter, man, you know.
Wait, so.
Okay, what's this guy about here and, you know, and everything. But, no, Travis checks out great. He, you know, I couldn't be happier, you know. I couldn't have found a better person to for my daughter to be, you know, hanging out with.
Let me ask you this. This is obviously just hypothetical, but if someone wanted to ask you for their daughter's hand in marriage, do they need to do it on the phone or in person?
Oh, I think in person would be the best way to do it. That's the way I would do it, you know.
Yeah.
I'm still kind of old school on that stuff, and I, you know, but you know, they need to bring a sack load of money with them.
Yeah,
like a dowry, probably the opposite dowry.
And knowing John, probably a couple Stellas, a couple Stella Artois.
Yeah, a few beers, a bunch of money. And,
yeah.
But no, you know, it's fun to watch. I call them kids still, you know, I mean, it's funny. You know, these kids are in their 20s now, but you know, me and the wife, we still call them kids, you know, and that's what they'll always be to us. But, you know, it's, you're always happy when your kid, you know, your child finds somebody else that you feel like is right for them. And, you know, and Madison and Travis just seem to really enjoy each other's company.
About your career for a second, you ever been on stage and kind of get caught up in the lyrics to Sold or forgot the lyrics to Sold? Because there are 362 words in that song. Like, is that a struggle to still remember?
Well, you know, as long as I don't think about it. If I think about it, it's over with. You know, and trust me, I have forgotten the words from time to time. And I learned out very early on in my career, especially when social media came along, if I forgot the words or mess up the words, I swear, or Be My Baby Tonight or Sold to Granite County Oxen, the next day on Facebook and all that, oh, my gosh. I mean, can you believe you forgot the words? I mean, you know, I mean, it's so, you know, I had to be paying a little bit more attention from now on. Like, okay, John, but really, I tell people the easiest song for me to sing is Sold because it's going so fast. You don't even think about, you know, you just boom, 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 and you know, and then if I do forget the words, you know, I just aim the mic at the fans and go,
y'all know this one.
Yeah. And, but hey, that's another thing. You know, Travis, I got to see him in action the other night. He played up here at Rupp Arena, and his entertainment skills. I mean, he's got everything. He's really good. You know, being on stage and engaging the crowd and everything. So he's got it going on.
Travis, do you feel like you should learn all of John Michael Montgomery's songs because you guys are close now?
You know, actually, and I've told him before, like one of my all-time favorite country songs ever is Letters from Home. So I know that one front to back. Me and John share a mutual love for Tony Lane, who's like one of my favorite songwriters ever who wrote that song. So I do know all the words to Letters from Home.
But I guess when it gets really serious, you'll learn Sold.
Yeah, for sure. Hey, like you said, it's got 9,700 words in it. It's like a book. You got to remember it all, yeah.
All right, hey, John Michael Montgomery. John, thank you for your time. We surprised Travis. A little
Absolutely.
Call from you. Our listeners love
it,
too.
Appreciate you guys having me on the show, and, you know, continued success.
All right, there he is. John Michael Montgomery.
Yeah. See you, Mr. John.
So I see you call him John.
Yeah.
Does anyone call him John Michael?
I call him, Crystal does. I call him Mr. John most of the time, and then every now and then I'll just JMM, you know, that's got a good ring to it.
It does not have a good ring to it.
JMM.
Travis Denning is here. We're going to come back. He's going to play in studio. I just wanted to do that first. Feel good. I saw you be a lot more.
Why would I know you were going to do something?
I saw
like
you be
that.
A lot more polite, and you sit up a little straighter when her dad got on the phone. You're like, oh, Mr. John, how are you, sir?
It's your girlfriend's dad. Right. That's what people are always like, is it different? And I'm like, no, it's just my girlfriend's dad. I mean, it just is what it is.
But her dad's John Michael Montgomery, so it is different. And you're a country, you're trying to be a country star.
Yeah.
Yeah, you got one hit on the way to Mindy, but I mean, you look up to those kind
of
guys.
Yeah. Also, was a little part of you like, oh, shoot, did he just hear me say that when I talk to him, it's almost like sometimes he's not listening?
No, it's because he's hard of hearing, and he knows that. It's like just sometimes you're like, hey, I caught a big fish today. He's like, what was that? I was like, I caught a big fish. He's like, oh, yeah, no, I've been fishing. You know, then that's okay. It's all good, though. He knows that. Well, yeah.
He is nominated for ACM New Male Artist of the Year. He is performed as one of the new faces, picked as one of the big new deals in country music. Look at you.
Come on.
I didn't vote for you. That's crazy. You got that.
Yeah, I know. It's amazing.
I know.
Been told I need a new face.
Boom. And also, the worst horse player in basketball I've ever seen.
Yeah.
We were playing basketball a couple days ago, and I had some crazy food poisoning, and I knew I still needed to go to this because we tried to do it before. It got pushed off, so I go, and I'm feeling terrible. I can't even see straight, and I still beat him.
Yeah, I mean, I am truly the worst basketball player ever.
You know who's good? Oddly, the guys from Lanco.
Yeah, they ball. Like they play all the time.
They ball hard.
All of them?
Deceiving got like a long ponytail and got facial hair, and you're like, this guy's coffee shop just plays the slow jams in the coffee shop with an acoustic guitar. Comes out just draining threes.
I mean, like couldn't miss.
Yeah, so terrible at basketball, good at music.
Yeah, it works. Yeah.
Tell me about this new song, Abby.
This is a song we put out Valentine's Day of 2020, so it's been out for a hot minute just on, you know, streaming and all that, but just a huge fan favorite. It's so creative, first time I heard it, I thought it was an amazing song and a funny way to spin a breakup, and so I'm pumped that it's going to radio.
First time we ever heard it, I think I paid Travis a couple bucks and he came to my house and played.
That's yeah. Right.
It's before he had a hit, though. Yeah, before he had a hit.
Uh-huh. Bones, was that 2 years ago?
Yeah.
It wasn't this last Christmas.
Yeah.
With the one
wow. Not this last Christmas, but the one before that.
It's like a year and a few months.
Travis brought his guitar, set up in the living room during our Christmas party, and played a bunch of songs. And then we couldn't get him to leave. Next morning, he's just rolling out of a guest room.
Well, I mean, I just thought it was such a pretty little place. I thought, yeah, might as well stay.
You have a big, big future ahead of you, my friend.
Thank you, brother.
The guy can play the crap out of a guitar.
Yes, he can.
Which you just don't expect. Damn. You guys stream Abby, go see Travis. Things are opening up. Do you have big plans? You probably can't announce them yet for a big tour.
A lot of stuff in the works for the fall, but we got some stuff in April and whatnot. So slowly but surely getting back.
Go over to the Instagram?
Yeah. What? Just the Instagram.
What is it?
Travis R. Denning.
Travis R. Denning.
Yeah, and I'm trying to up my TikTok, you know. Yep. It's not going very well. So
All right, there he is, Travis Denning. See you soon, bud.
Thanks, man. It's about